Facebook groups are huge and becoming bigger and bigger. Maybe you run one and you need to know how to create an event in a Facebook group. Today I'll show you not only how to do it, but how to use the best practices that I use with my clients. Let's get into it. What's up, busy people? Welcome to 5 Minute Social Media. My name is Jerry Potter. This is where busy business owners get together to rock their social media without wasting a bunch of time that we don't have. If this is your first time watching one of our videos, welcome. And if you've watched before but haven't subscribed, consider subscribing today and supporting the channel. By the end of this video, you're gonna know how to create an event in your Facebook group, as well as the best practices to utilize to make sure that the most people are reached. So when you're in your Facebook group, go ahead and click Events over here on the left side. Then you're going to go to Create Event. Now what we'll do is we'll just start from the top down and go through each of the different areas. First up is your event photo or video. Now, this is what's going to be your attention grabber in somebody's feed if they don't actually come to your group all the time. So it's important to make sure that this is something that will get people's attention. You can do a video if you've got a good video for that. Got my photo here. Kind of catches your attention, hopefully, as you're going through a Facebook news feed. Now, a lot of people like to put a bunch of text on their photograph here for their event. Don't do that. Don't make it look like a sleazy nightclub flyer, if you've ever seen one of those. If your event has more than 20% text on it, Facebook will not give it the reach that it deserves. With anything with a lot of text, Facebook is going to punish in the algorithm. So your best bet is a nice photograph. It used to be that it would show up different sizes on different platforms, but now you can make it the same size for all platforms. 1920 by 1080 should be perfect. For your event name, keep it short, because this will also get cut off on some platforms. For example, if your event is the 27th Annual Royal Festival of Beer and Networking, that's probably too long, even though it fits. Get rid of all of that and just call it Beer and Networking Festival. If you need to, down here in the description, you can put in the 27th annual, or if you really want to, you could add that at the end if you think the heritage is important, something like that. But make sure the first part is the most important part of your name. So I'm going to call this Free Webinar. Okay. Location. You can put in a place or an address. If there is a Facebook page associated with the location, definitely make sure that you tag that. For example, if I start typing in Starbucks, you see all these different Starbucks coming up. So those are actual locations. If you have an actual location or page here, then the algorithm should help it reach people that are fans of that location or page or that have been to that location. So otherwise, you can just put in any address if you want. For this, I will say website. Link coming soon, we'll say. Next, choose your frequency. Is this a one-time event? This is another feature that Facebook added, which is great. Now you can have them daily, weekly. Under daily, you can see. You can have a start date and an end date, and it's every day from these times. Or you can come down and customize the dates and times. Weekly, you can have it at the same time every week. Or if you want to do fully custom, you can come in here and build some really complex stuff. But the great part is you don't have to create your events over and over again. You can have one event that just continues on. Plus, as people engage and like and say they're interested or that they're going to your event gains momentum with the algorithm. So this was a huge upgrade. So for this demonstration, though, we'll just say occurs once, 10 a.m. to 10 p.m. It's a 12-hour webinar. Sure, nobody will be sick of me by then. Then you've got the description box. What else do you need to tell people about your event? You've already done the date, the time, the name of it. That's where you want to put all the other information. You can put a lot of information on this box. However, in some views, people will only see the first couple of lines, or they might only read the first couple of lines. So in this situation, you want to put the most important information in those first two lines. Avoid long text like, "We sure hope you will join us for this wonderful affair." This has told people nothing. Let's try this. So now I've just got a couple of lines, basic information about what it is and what we're going to do. Then down here, I can add more information if I want to. Finally, at the bottom, do you want to invite all members of your group? If so, then leave that checked. If not, leave it unchecked and then go ahead and hit create.
So that's how you create a Facebook event in your group. Now, it's important to know who can see your event.
In a Facebook group, the privacy settings for an event are going to match the settings of the Facebook group. So if you have a public group, that means anybody could stumble across your event. Now, if your Facebook group is closed or secret, only people in your Facebook group will be able to see the event. In fact, if somebody in your group tries to share it with somebody else, they'll log in and get an error saying this content can't be shown. Now, before you go, one of my favorite things to do is to coach people on Facebook events, because there are so many things you can do that people aren't taking advantage of to reach more people. So I put together this video, Dominate Facebook Events, with these 10 tips. They're all completely free. Check that video out now, and thank you for watching 5 Minute Social Media. Take a second to give this video a like, a comment, and consider subscribing. You're not only supporting me, but also my two tiny superheroes at home.